CFO and our elected officials to stand up for us and for our fish, and not these Norwegian monstrosities that are being fed food from Chile, starving one ocean and polluting another.
But I wanted to say this about the DFO. This is not new. This is endemic. It's deeply rooted. It goes back to before the Comanche Completion Project, when they were forced to make political decisions instead of just scientific ones.
This is a crime. It's literally a crime. We're not making this up. These people who, for whom we've vested the responsibility to look after our nation's fisheries, are squandering their opportunity to do so. If you go to the communities on the East Coast where the cod crashed, you find families devastated, fishermen devastated, communities wiped out, because these people, the Canadian Department of Fisheries and Oceans, did not do their job to look after our fisheries. And they're now doing it on the West Coast, and that's why we're here saying no. Alex has done the scientific research and work that these people, the Department of Fisheries, should have been doing all these years and all these decades.
Their intent to continue to expand this this industry is going to do more harm than good. And that's what the fish farm industry wants to do. And years down the road, they'll be saying, look, we've got even more millions of dollars, but it's going to be at a tragic expense at our wild salmon and the other biodiversity around these fish farms.
I would like DFO to take the salmon feedlots out of the ocean. I'd like them to suck all the waste up off the seafloor and put it in barges and take it to a toxic waste dump. I'd like them to show the Norwegian industry the door, and I'd like them to work with Canadians to build an on-land industry. The memo that came out in the Cohen Inquiry is so shocking because they call the Canadian public's feeling towards salmon farming a crisis. Not the demise of wild salmon, but the way the Canadian public feels about the salmon farms is a crisis. And they were talking about being their public relations. So the taxes we're paying DFO to look after our wild fish, in fact, a large part of them are going to promoting salmon farming to us, which is basically pulling the wool over our eyes. It's a lie. The industry is not sustainable. We've just started the votesalmon.ca, going and chasing down candidates and asking them, if you are elected, will you stand for us and our wild salmon and remove these salmon feedlots? Everybody is saying yes. Nobody has stood up and said they support salmon farms, not even the conservatives in the riding where the salmon farms exist.
I'm not sure that there's going to be a political solution until the people of Canada, the people of British Columbia are going to have to stand up. I think the solution comes from us. I haven't seen yet any indication that the politicians have the courage to do the right thing, to stand up to international corporations on behalf of their own people. It almost seems to me at times that our government's not working for us anymore. They're working for the oil companies or the fishing companies or somebody else. And I think that for our government to work for us, we're going to have to demand it.